a vinyl community and welcome YouTubers from everywhere and all you playboys. Chet Baker and Art Pepper, recorded 1956. This is the 2010 Jazz Classics Reissue Limited Direct Metal Master. Pretty nice record. I got this at my store and it maybe been played once. It was open, but it was mint. So hope you enjoy a little Playboy music. Do a little quickie video here today. Also picked up this record, The Erotic Delights of Lady C, Lady Chatterley's Lover. It's a fun record. I thought this kind of fit in with Playboy's. This record, 1960, about a $10 record, but on Discogs, 20 people have it, 68 people want it. So, just because these records might be a little cheesy, doesn't mean that people don't want them. In that vein, Vinyl Rundown did a contest entry for me, and he showed this record. And I'd never seen this record before. I thought it was fun. There's the back side, but this one still has the promo sticker on it with the special instructions inside. Hey guys, don't pick up this record, for your significant other, unless it has the instructions. Now, I was hoping there would be some pictures in these instructions, but she's just telling you how to do it. Going through the new arrivals at my store, I happened to find this. Boom! Promo copy, not for sale. The Sun, the Moon, and Herbs, Dr. John, from 1971. Gatefold. Pretty hard to find one in this good a condition. And not only that, white label promo, Monarch pressing, first pressing. They had the record graded G plus. You look at the record, man, it looks VG plus. It's really clean looking. But when you play it, there's no skips or anything, but it's a little bit too noisy. I'm still happy to have it. And boy, great music on this record. So I was checking my Discogs when I logged this in. Well, it turned out not too long ago, I was wanting this record and they're hard to find and get a little pricey, so I picked up this one. Music on Vinyl, 2017. I'm not going to take this one out, so I had to do a little comparison last night. I played the original. You know, it was noisy, but otherwise it sounded good. How about this record? This record sounded outstanding. I'd say the first press promo maybe had just a little bit more low end, but because of the noise, you didn't get the best of the higher frequencies, and boy, this record really sounded good. So if you want the Night Tripper and you can't find one or don't want to pay the price for a really clean one, this music on vinyl, I think, is still available. Pick it up. Music for Playboys, or it's those Playboys playing the music. You know, from our outlaw country stuff here not long ago, they showed this record, so it's over at my store. VG++, $10. We all know that's a good record. The more things change, the more things stay the same. So we have a Playboys record here. We like that cheesecake cover. Well, this cover, not cheesecake, but the name of the band is Psychedelic Porn Crumpet.
Thank you.
they're still keeping that same mentality going, aren't they? Gatefold. Where'd I find out about this record? Here recently, Michael Fremmer did an over 2-hour video at GZ Media. Was really interesting, and if you have any interest in the record pressing and the quality control, go watch that video. This particular record was in the video. He showed the hand press where they're doing fancy vinyl and have to do them one at a time, and I thought, man, that colored vinyl looks great. I'm going to hunt for this record and buy it just because of the vinyl. Well, we got a music clip in here, and psychedelic porn crumpets, but several of the commenters said the only thing psychedelic was the cover. Well, at any rate, this is a new group. This is their fourth record. They just been around a little while. Comes with a nice inner sleeve. Here's the reason I ordered it. Pretty fancy three-color splatter. You can watch the video and you can watch them press this record, a few of them. So I thought that was kind of fun. Almost forgot this one. Have to slip it in. Tron. This record originally, 1982, soundtrack for the movie. This particular edition, audio fidelity, limited edition, 180 gram pure virgin vinyl, specially remastered for this LP by Kevin Gray and pressed at Quality Record Pressing, Salina, Kansas. 3,000 of these were limited to, number 1957 I have, and Wendy Carlos did most of the music for this. Michael Fremmer been showing his 100 all analog records still in print, still available, so I had to pick this up. Tip-on gatefold jacket, first class all of the way. And I'll show you just one of the records. They're both similar here. Some beautiful translucent cobalt vinyl. And hey, it sounds as good as it looks. Want to wish the vinyl community happy trails. And I say, keep them spinning.
Happy trails to you until we meet again.